nursing pillows, car seats, high chairs, they may all contain a chemical linked to cancer.
There's a new study out warning that 80% of baby products may contain this chemical. Sanjay Gupta joins us from Atlanta. You know, we talk about this all the time. You have three little girls, three little boys, two kids, and we always worry, are the products that we're using, putting them on, you know, putting on them safe?
Yeah, and one of the things that we've been researching this for a long time, as you mentioned, is, you know, we're surrounded by chemicals all the time, about 80,000 chemicals, and a very small number of them have been tested. So the answer to the question is, you know, as Christine said before, potentially toxic chemicals, as we just don't know the truth about some of these chemicals. We don't know the cause and effect relationship that people are really looking for. But you're absolutely right. It's been this balance for some time when it comes to flame retardants in particular. They want to find good flame retardants for obvious reasons, and part of that involves using some of these chemicals. So in this particular study, they found that out of about 100 products surveyed, 80 of them had some of these flame retardants in them. And one of these flame retardants in particular, called TDCPP, that's been studied. It was banned back in the 70s, or at least removed from children's pajamas back in the 1970s. And it's back now because people use it as a good flame retardant with real concerns about potential effects on your DNA, potential effects causing cancer. So, you know, children are being exposed to more of these chemicals than ever before, again, because of the risks and benefits. You want to get some of the benefits of flame retardants, but the risk potential of these chemicals.
You know, and Sanjay, our lives have changed so much from the 70s, so now we are surrounded by consumer products. Our kids are sitting on car. I mean, you know, maybe there's testing for the exposure for one part of that, but they're being surrounded by it by so many different ways to be exposed. Why are kids so susceptible?
Well, you know, part of it is that there are just a lot more chemicals. A lot of them are not tested, and kids are being born even pre-polluted. This is something that we found in the documentary as well. Umbilical cord blood, Christine, to your point, before a child is even born, has up to 200 of these chemicals in that blood. So they're getting exposed more than ever before. They are not just small adults, children. Don't think of them that way, but they're more susceptible because they metabolize a lot of these chemicals more quickly. Their organs are still developing, so they're more susceptible to these chemicals. And obviously, they're going to have a much longer impact. If you've been exposed to these chemicals later in life, the impact will be less. One of the big things, this is just a practical point. You mentioned that I have three small children. A lot of these types of chemicals end up accumulating close to the ground, on the ground and floor of your house. Children spend a lot of time on the ground. They put their hands on the ground. They touch their hands to their mouth. That's a route of exposure, and it's a significant one. You know, simply taking off your shoes when you enter the home, that can actually significantly reduce the amount of chemicals that you're dragging into the house from the outside, obviously cleaning up a lot of the dust. Also, that new sort of furniture smell that you often smell and think that's people, you know, like that off curtains, off of furniture. Oftentimes, that can be a sign of some of these same chemicals. So making sure you ventilate around those that furniture really well, or, you know, you're not necessarily finding or wanting that new furniture smell. Household plants can help absorb some of these chemicals as well. These are some simple things we do in our home because we are surrounded, as you say, by so many of these chemicals.
Sanjay, I opened a playpen yesterday, brand new one out of the box, and I could smell it. It smelled like plastic. It smelled brand new.
And I told you, you have to off-gas it. You gotta take it outside.
She talks about off-gassing. I dragged it into the dining room and opened the windows. You know, I mean, maybe I'm crazy, but I'm not putting the baby in it yet.
I don't think so. And let me just say really quick, inside your home is oftentimes more dangerous than outside your home for some of these same reasons. You think you go inside to get away from some of these exposures? Open up the windows, let the ventilation, as you say, occur. That can help as well.
Oh, man, in allergy season, it's like you don't know which way is worse.
I know.
All the pollen
That's another
coming
risk
in.
Benefit.
Oh,
right?
I know.
All right, Sanjay. Great to talk to you as always. Thanks.